What is the five around drop? It's basically what you're doing is you're canvassing prospects who are in close geographic proximity to your current client. So for example, we are in an office building. I own the two different like suites. I guess it's just technically three, but I own, you know, because they were originally separated. So I own like three suites that we are in, right? Well, there's a financial advisor, there's a real estate firm, there's other people in that building. And so if you were my MSP, you could go walk in and introduce yourselves to the people in the building because they know us. And you could say, hey, you know, we do IT for TMT who's down the hallway, you know, and or downstairs. And just I was here visiting with them and thought I would just drop in and introduce myself. That is what canvassing five around drop. Now, canvassing, just to be clear, is physically walking into the offices of a business for the purpose of introducing yourself and generating leads. And it's not a new idea. You will hear of political candidates doing canvassing. They go out and door knock, vote for Pedro or whatever, right? You know, and so that's canvassing. Some of our Mormon brothers and sisters, I think they go on walkabout or whatever they call it, and they go out and they try to convert people. That's like a form of canvassing. I'm pretty sure the Mary Kay ladies did that at one point. They go knock on doors and canvass. So there's like, you know, there's people sell magazines and so forth who do it. So what we're not selling anything. So you're not knocking on someone's door to try and get them to vote for somebody, to change their political views, to have them embrace a religion. And we're not trying to get a check out of them. Canvassing really is just, it's like another media of getting your marketing materials in the door of somebody. Now, that's what canvassing is. Now, the five around drop, what makes that unique is it's what I tell clients is take one customer and at least canvass the five businesses that are in their building, in their office park, on the block, whatever, right? If you can. Now, I know some of them might be out in the middle of nowhere and there's no five around that you can do. All right. Okay, fine. Yes. And there might be a building that they're in where there's 100 offices of different businesses. So I know I get that. But in general, the reason we five around, it's kind of a real estate thing. So if you're in real estate, and this is true. So the average person in any neighborhood knows five of their neighbors. That's like in general, right? Now, so like in our neighborhood, I'm trying to think, I know I know them. So I know about three, okay? Dan knows everybody because he's on the homeowners. So I don't know if you take the average, but yeah, so some people know nobody and some people know 20. The average for most people is they know five of their neighbors. So the reason five around is you're trying to do the five people who are in the closest proximity to your customer, and you're just dropping off some information and introducing yourself. That's the entirety of what you're doing. All right. Now, where I first discovered this, I actually don't want to take credit for this because it was one of my long-term members, Mr. John Tate. I don't wonder where John is today, because he sold his company, SnapStreak. He sold it to another company several years ago. I mean, probably over 5 or 6 years ago. John was actually in one of my original Genius League memberships, you know, and we would, you know, we'd get together every quarter. And one of the things John emailed me, he said, hey, do you want to hear about a new thing I'm doing for marketing that brought in over $250,000 in sales with new clients? And I'm like, nah, dog, you know, keep that shit at home. I'm like, yeah, of course I want to know. What did you do? Right. And what he was doing was canvassing, what I'm talking about. Now, not even five around drop, but actual canvassing. So this is where I first, you know, learned of it. Now, here's what John was doing. He started with medical centers because medical centers kind of cluster together, so they're easier to canvass. And he didn't entirely focus on medical as his niche, but he had a lot of medical clients. So he just started with, he said, all right, let's go to medical parks. And then he used this really simple, get out of computer trouble-free business card. So it was just literally a business card that they would drop off. And he had a college kid do the canvassing. And when this kid would go out, he would literally walk into a medical office, introduce himself, say, I don't even know what the kid's name was, Billy Bob from Snapstreak. We're an IT company, and I just wanted to drop this off. It's a get out of computer trouble free card for, you know, we're an IT firm. We're just wanting to introduce ourselves. And if you have any issue that you got going on, let us know. And what John said, that was it. That was the, and oh, and then he would ask to get the business cards. He would take some of the doctor, can I get a business card? Because a lot of times the doctors have the business cards sitting out. So he would just take them if they weren't there. He would say, may I please get a business card, right? So that was it. And when John told me every time that kid went out, he said there would be somebody, he would walk in the office and they'd say, God, I'm so glad you showed up. We actually are having a problem right now, or we've got it. We're really frustrated with our current somebody. And so what the kid would do is he'd make a note and he would walk out in the parking lot, call John and say, hey, call Mary. She's the office manager here at XYZ, you know, OBGYN office or whatever the office was. And they're having this issue. And then John would call in and talk. And just that simple process, $250,000 in new sales with just a simple business card and a college kid that is actually pretty articulate, I guess, you know, he was a sharp kid, right? That's it. So once that got out, then a whole bunch of my members started using canvassing, because that's kind of what, it's like an idea virus, right? You get like, somebody gets a campaign that works and they hear about it working. And then everybody wants to do that campaign. So, you know, it bubbled up. It started taking root. So why canvassing? It works and it's inexpensive and it's simple, because I know there are some people who are watching this session who are brand new, who might be a startup, and they're sitting there going, I don't have any clients to do a QBR with. I don't have any break fix customers to convert. I don't have any customers to get a test. What am I supposed to do? I'm like rubbing two sticks together to try and make a fire here, right? So this is a way that you can start your prospecting list building. It's really simple. It's really inexpensive, and it works.